Two people are walking through a bare, cold wood. The moon keeps pace with them and draws their gaze. The moon moves along above tall oak trees. There is no wisp of cloud to obscure the radiance to which the black, jagged tips reach up. A woman's voice speaks. I'm carrying a child, and not by you. I'm walking here with you in a state of sin. I have offended grievously against myself. I despaired of happiness, and yet I still felt a grievous longing for life's fullness, for a mother's joys and duties. And so I sinned, and so I yielded, shuddering, my sex to the embrace of a stranger, and even thought myself blessed. Now life has taken its revenge, and I have met you, met you. She walks on, stumbling. She looks up. The moon keeps pace. Her dark gaze drowns in light. A man's voice speaks. Do not let the child you have conceived be a burden on your soul. Look how brightly the universe shines. Splendor falls on everything around. You are voyaging with me on a cold sea, but there is the glow of an inner warmth from you in me, from me in you. That warmth will transfigure the stranger's child, and you bear it me, begot by me. You have transfused me with splendor. You have made a child of me. He puts an arm about her strong hips. Their breath embraces in the air. Two people walk on through the high, bright night.
Thank you. Thank you.
When falling asleep. Now that the day has worn me down, the star-strewn night in mercy mild graciously accepts my fierce demands as if those of a weary child. Hands, leave off from all your doing. Brow, forget every thinking. All of my five senses now wish to be in slumber sinking. Thence to soar in boundless flight, the unwatched soul freely gives itself in the magic sphere of night, deep and thousandfold to live.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.